You know, cameras have been around for a while. I think cameras have been around. I know I've seen photographs that were taken during the Civil War. Obviously, right. You know, they were not very sophisticated, but there were cameras around. We live in an age of selfies.
Yes.
Now, I want to tell you something.
When did that start?
Not 25 years ago. Yeah. Not 15 years ago.
Cameras on your phone.
I mean, this is a new phenomenon.
Mm-hmm. Years ago, you go on vacation and you take pictures of people
and stuff. Yes.
Now you take a picture of you with the stuff. It's totally backwards the way it used to be.
It's interesting. Maybe I find it interesting because I just happened flipping through the news the other day. I was watching a news show and there was just a clip they were showing from some professional sport game. I don't even know what it was, a baseball game. It was a baseball game or a basketball game. And they showed this group of girls, maybe like 10 girls, and they're in the stands at this game. Mm-hmm. They're not paying any attention to the game whatsoever. And they showed them, and they had the camera on these girls, and all they're doing is taking pictures of themselves at the game. There is such a focus on self that we have come to incorporate this into our language, this whole phenomena of selfies, that people are so engrossed taking pictures of themselves, all right?
It's reinforced in everything we hear and say.
But selfies is not about the camera. No. It's about the attitude that's underlying.
Right.
It's about I'm what's important.
Right.
You know, I'm what my world revolves around me, so I got to take pictures of me. Being a lover of self, you know, years ago, Alice and I were in California, and I was going somewhere to preach, and we had stopped at a McDonald's on the way. I think we were going from Los Angeles up to the Bay Area, San Francisco Bay Area. So when I got to this church that Sunday morning, God gave me a sermon, and my sermon was, I know that the world is coming to an end because I got ice in my Diet Coke and pickles on my hamburger. Now, if that puts a little, is that quizzical? Okay. Here's the reason why. Because one of the signs, the first sign here of the last days is being a lover of self. You know, everything is a matter of balance. And it says an unjust balance is an abomination to the Lord. And I'm going to tell you the truth. The more you love yourself in this worldly way, the less capacity you have to love others.
That's right.
Because your attention is focused on yourself rather than on others. So, you know, stopping in this place, and it was so common. I at that time, I used to drink a lot of Diet Coke. I don't anymore. And I would always ask for the Diet Coke without water.
Ice.
Frozen water. I'm only half wrong. Frozen water. And it was the rarest thing in the world for me to get it without ice.
That's right.
And I asked for, I don't want any pickles on the hamburger. Well, I get the hamburger with pickles and I get the Diet Coke with ice. Why? Because the person behind the counter, generally a young person, but not necessarily, they were focused on something other than me, the customer, when they were taking my order. Maybe they were thinking about a date they had that evening or something.
They just weren't thinking.
But they were thinking about themselves rather than about me. Mm-hmm. Because when you're a lover of self, you become careless about others. Now, think about that, right? Carelessness, just take the word. Yes. It's just caring less. Caring less about what? Others. Yes. You're caring about yourself. Your focus is yourself, right?
For the dying, don't seem easy, but it must be daily done. To live the life that you have given in the fullness of the sun. There is so much I am missing, yet there is so much that I see. Freedom isn't really freedom, it doesn't bind my heart. If it's not in much or little, if it's not in big or small, it'll be beyond the present likeness to see the fullness of all. For I hear your voices calling, sometimes.